But when you're in another one of your college classes and you happen to run into someone that you remember seeing from another one of your college classes, how's it going, you guys? Welcome back. So, I think it's safe to say that one of the biggest fears that a lot of students have before the first day of school is not being able to make any friends. And nothing says that you're a long way from home than your first day of college, especially when you're sitting in a classroom surrounded by other college students that you've never met before. I know the word college sounds scary, and based on all the Hollywood movies we have seen, college certainly looks pretty crazy too. But don't worry, you guys, and trust me when I say that you're going to make tons of awesome new friends at college. Making new friends is going to happen no matter what, because it's seriously impossible to not make any friends in college. And if anyone is wondering, yes, imaginary friends still count as friends, so you're still good. Have you not seen Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends? Moving on, the way you made tons of new friends in high school is going to be the same way you're going to make friends in college. Or if you haven't made any friends in high school, then this is your second chance at making new friends in school. But before you start making all these new friends of yours, there is going to be a very short and brief period of time where you don't have any friends. So the better question we need to be asking is, for that brief period of time, can you survive college with no friends until you start making some? And my answer to that question is absolutely. You can 100% totally survive college with no friends for that brief period of time, if and only if you play your cards right. Because until you build up your squad that got your back no matter what, laying low and not making any enemies is going to be very important here. Which brings me to rule number one, don't create enemies. For someone to be considered an enemy, that person had to do something really bad and seriously crossed a line in the sand that should have never ever be crossed by anyone. In high school, things operate pretty smoothly because everyone has an assigned seat in the classroom and no one is allowed to take your seat. But in college, it's like the Wild Wild West over here, and there is no such thing as having an assigned seat. You're literally allowed to sit anywhere you want in a college classroom, and it's totally acceptable. So for about the first week of college, everyone is going to be playing musical chairs and start sitting at different seats so they can try them out. But at around the second week, you will start to notice that everyone in the classroom is going to be sitting at the same seat and not move from their spot, because for whatever reason, they feel comfortable sitting there, and that's the seat that they have chosen as their seat. This is what you call someone's unofficial, official assigned classroom seat for that class, because after the first week of college, and everyone is nice and settled in the seat that they have chosen for themselves, there is absolutely no take backs, and you're stuck with that seat. So if someone always sits at a certain seat, and out of nowhere, you just randomly sit on that person's seat, you have now officially become a seat thief. And now good luck trying to make friends with that person. Because let's say you need to borrow a pen because you don't have one and the teacher is writing notes on the board and you know you have to write them down. You are no longer going to be a classmate in need of help and just needs to borrow a pen to that person now. Because to that person, it's going to be, oh, looky, looky, looky. Mr. Seat Thief over here needs to borrow a pen. Do you need to borrow a pen, Mr. Seat Thief? Because I'm sorry, I'm using all 5 of these pens that I have right here on my desk. I know this may sound weird to a lot of people, but hey, I don't make the rules here in college. I just follow them. So don't be a seat thief, okay? The reason why I'm telling you this is because I know I can't tell you how to make friends, because we all make friends differently, but I can mostly certainly tell you how to not make any enemies in college. Which now brings me to rule number 2, create an alliance system. Most of the first few friends that you are going to make in college are going to be from all the different college classes you are taking. And when you're in college, it's going to be a small world and you will run into the same people over and over again. And there is one unwritten college rule that everyone follows, and that's being friends or friendly with people you have more than one college class with. Because when you take a college class, everyone you see starts off as a stranger that you don't know. But when you're in another one of your college classes and you happen to run into someone that you remember seeing from another one of your college classes, that person is a familiar face and gets an automatic hello from you. And there is a very high chance that you will sit next to that person and be friends with them. Because if you happen to see the same person that you have more than one class with, being friends with that person has its many rewards. All I'm saying is, if you don't say hello to that person, or at least be friendly to them, good luck trying to be friends with that person now. You're going to be known as the jerk who is too good enough to say hello to people that you constantly run into. And now that's one less person you can become friends with for two classes now. And last but not least, we are at rule number three, and that's getting people on your good side. When it comes to making friends, it's either you're going to them and starting a conversation with them, or they're coming to you and starting a conversation with you. Rule number three covers both angles, and it works perfectly well. Since we're living in the age of technology, this rule works best on the first day of school and will for sure 100% guarantee get tons of people to want to be on your side. And all you have to do is just bring your laptop to class and go to typelikeahacker.com. You need to have your laptop open and ready, and as soon as someone sits next to you, that's when you start typing like a madman on your laptop and have a super serious focused look on your face. You have to keep on typing non-stop for about 15 seconds. And do you want to know why? Have you ever heard of the saying, curiosity kill the cat? The person next to you is going to be curious, and I mean real curious on what you're typing, and their wandering eyes are going to get a real quick peek of your laptop screen. As soon as they start seeing all this crazy madness being typed on your laptop screen, and you're the one doing all the typing, that person is going to automatically think that you're some kind of super smart computer hacker now, or some secret spy who's hired by the CIA and is good with computers. Yeah, the class you're both taking is Psychology 101, but you know that person next to you is going to think that they're sitting next to a computer hacker. And at this point, all you have to do is just minimize your window, close your laptop, and just look at the other person and say, "What's up?" All I'm saying is, I know for a fact that this person is not going to even think about stealing your seat now. And for sure, that person now wants to be on your good side, because who knows what you're capable of doing. But that'll be it for this video. Leave me a comment down below. When it comes to making friends, do you go to other people and start conversations with them, or do they come to you and start conversations with you? So if you enjoyed this video, feel free to smash that like button. And if you're new to the channel, feel free to subscribe, and I'll see you all next time.